Honorable Justice Lakshman, my good friend Sir Jagmohan Singh, the moving spirit behind the NRI Institute, ladies and gentlemen, I thought I should give a bit of advice. Maybe it runs contrary to what Mr. Janija has said, that many of you would be educating here. I know that you have a lot of problems when you invest money in India. I have been a policeman for nearly 40 years, and I know what it is to be con man. When you invest your money, kindly do make sure that you have taken all the precautions, because I have seen, unfortunately in our country, too many frauds, too many cheatings, including of my own relatives, where I put up on them. So Bernard Shaw said a fool and his money are spoon parted. So I would advise you that before you invest, I don't say India is not the best of destination, it has the best of companies, it has the best of people. But still there are a lot of suckers around, and which only you can guard. Despite the Honorable Justice Lakshman's efforts, the legal system in our country is so slow. And you would be surprised if I told you the largest case, the oldest case in India is 173 years old. It's pending, pending in Calcutta High Court. And it was filed in Lord Curzon's time, saying to whom these properties belong, where, you know, Victoria Memorial is situated, High Court, Writers Building, other things here. It's 173 years. The condition was, our court said at that time, that he will pay one rupee a month every year till the disposal of the case. And he still, successors are still paying that 1 rupee a day, 365 rupees a year. So the government will get here their case disposed of here. So but apart from that, let me give you an idea. I know Justice Lakshman has been trying his best to reduce the pendencies in the country. It is not to scare you, but so far as Supreme Court is concerned, highest court in India, as of 1st November 2008, these are the figures, 49,263 cases are pending, 18 high courts have 38,150 cases pending, and some of them, like in Allahabad, have 8,87,000. Madras has 4,46,975. So far as lower courts are concerned, this is about 2.90 crores. About 10 crore Indians are waiting for the justice. So when you come and file a complaint that why I am not getting a justice here, the fault doesn't lie in the judiciary, it lies in the system. All over the world, there should be 50 judges per million population. This is a recommendation of Law Commission also. We have somewhere 9.75. America has some 160. England, Europe has 110 to 130. So, I thought I must caution you that when you say that you will go to the court here, please avoid going to the court. I remember, I think for something I was talking to Mr. Chidambaram when he was practicing. In a position I put. He said, my advice is there as far as possible avoid going to the court, because you are stuck up either this way or so. As I said here, there are no people you could decide. For instance, take a simple thing like terrorism, which is written in this country. I have to give credit to the government. They tried their best in the Unlawful Activities Act to say, put the onus on the accused terrorist to show that he is not terrorist. For vote bank politics, allies didn't agree. They did not to be used to target minority interests. So the present law is that tomorrow you want to prove that Kasab or somebody was done in Bombay, you have to produce evidence that he is terrorist. I doubt it very much whether any Pakistani government or Lashkar-e Taiba will come forward to India to depose in a court that we trained him, we sent him on this one. So confession made before a police officer is not visible. You have to inevitably produce it. So I thought that this is something which is very, very essential to bring to your notice here. Now you have some problems, we can understand that. Number one is unhelpful embassies. I have repeatedly hammered this point here. The Indian Foreign Service is really foreign. It is not the Indian. It may, they may be from India, but they are probably not from the service of Indian citizens here. Even when I go abroad, I make it a point not to telephone anybody, tell anybody. The responsibility I have a dead man. Nothing will ever happen. So you have to stand on your own feet. You have to make sure that whatever money you invest, you have proper safeguards. I know in democracy there are certain limitations also. You have the certain crop. And I think people who thought that they will make millions and billions, they have been not exactly paupers. They have been, their wealth has been considerably lightened here. The only beneficiaries have been the people who manipulated the books here. And I don't know, there is, in spite of a company like Pricewaterhouse, if they can be party to fudging, what can the law commission do, what can the courts do on this one also here? So, please, and it is not that fraud doesn't happen. It has happened even in the largest banks of UK, where somebody I think made it bankrupt and he was, I forget his name, a couple of years ago he was caught in Singapore. But the only thing you can send him is to jail. You don't recover the money.